In this tutorial video, you will learn the difference between point type and area type in Adobe Illustrator and when you should use them. The first one we'll cover is the point type. If we click on the type tool, to create point type, you simply have to click once on an empty area of your artboard and then type your text. Notice that as you continue typing, it's going to continue in a straight line unless you manually force it to break by hitting enter or return on your keyboard. So you can technically create multi-line text with the point type feature, but it's probably not the best use of this. What you want to use the point type feature for is for things like titles or short phrases, headings, or anything you want to appear on one line. The reason why is because what we can do once we grab the selection tool, we can actually transform this text and we can resize it and move it on the fly. So if I grab it, I can resize this text and move it wherever I need it to be. Now, one thing I want to point out about this is when you're resizing the text using this method, you should definitely hold the shift key to constrain the proportions so that you're not getting a skewed font that sort of reduces the integrity of that font style. So once we've got our title the way we want it, what we actually want to do is create a subtitle. So I'm going to go ahead and use all capitals and type history of. And I want to tuck it into this space right here. So this is another benefit of using point type. Because this is on one line and because I used point type, I can now rearrange these two types of text like puzzle pieces. So I can go ahead and tuck this one up here and I can resize it as needed, remembering to hold shift so that I don't skew it or squash it. And right now I'm just going to leave it like that because that's not exactly the font that I wanted to use for this, and I'll go back and redesign it a little bit later. But right now I've used point type to create a pretty cool layout with my text. Now area type is different. It's not meant for one line text. It's meant for paragraphs. So if you have a multiple line text situation, what you need to do is take that text, and I'm going to go ahead and just copy this working text right here and move back over to my design. And we're still going to use the type tool. It's a little confusing because you have an area type tool. This is really meant for if you already have a shape like a circle or a heart or whatever it may be. If you click on it, it will fill in that shape with your text. But the area type option when using the type tool is a little bit different. What you do with this is you're just going to click and drag out a shape that you want your text to appear in, and it's going to constrain itself to the boundaries of that shape. So if I were to just type, notice that as I type and it hits the edge, it automatically wraps. So this is really great for multi-line text. I'll go ahead and delete this and paste in the text that I took from over here. And notice that it's constraining itself to the boundaries of the box that I drew. I can grab the selection tool and move it up and position it the way I want it, and that looks pretty good. Now the thing you need to know about this is when you go to transform the bounding box, you're actually transforming the shape that the text conforms to, but you're not resizing it as you did with a point type. So to resize the text with this, you either have to click the entire text box and resize it that way, or you would come in here and highlight an area and resize that particular area manually. So let's go ahead and undo those couple of changes and talk about one more feature that has to do with area type. Notice that when I have my type in here, it's not nearly what I had actually copied. If you look over here, we have this little red plus sign in the bottom right hand corner, and this is overset text. What that means is that there's more text in this text box, but you can't see it because the text box is not big enough. So what you can do with this is you can actually create columns using threaded text. To do that, with the selection tool, I'm just going to click on this plus sign and click one more time until you get a loaded cursor. And you can tell it's loaded because it kind of has that little fake text icon, whatever, next to it that tells you that it's loaded with all that extra text from here. So I can draw my next column, and it's a little too big, but right now we can see the thread going from the first to the second. So this is actually the out port and this is the in port. And notice it still has overset text, so I can create another column if I wanted to. But for right now, I need to actually resize these because they're getting a little bit too crowded. So I can move this over. Make sure to create nice, good space between them. And I think that looks pretty good. So again, you want to use point type for titles or headings, and you want to use area type or area type option, so to speak, when you have multi-line text. The last thing we just need to do is change the actual styling of these so that it looks pretty good. So I'm going to do a color palette of gray and red. So I'm going to keep both of these Helvetica so that we have some consistency. I'll just make this one Helvetica bold. And then this text, since it's our big heading, we can do something a little bit fancier, has a little bit more style. This would be really hard to read for body text like this. So we're going to use this to be our standout piece. And we're going to coordinate with the rest of the illustration by using a red color palette. And notice I can move each one of these like little puzzle pieces because I use that point type. So I can stretch it out and align it on the right and left. And there we go. We have our final finished piece.